Welcome to Beneath the Steel Sky, I'm your host Lostwolfe, this is episode 8. And when I last left you, Robert had managed to do some stuff in Link space, and he got himself a bit of knowledge. So we're going to go back to this terminal. Welcome to Link. Please insert your card. Okay, let's do that. And we've seen all the stuff that we can see, but the important thing I want to make a note of very quickly is that Reich Stevens' link status is 5. 5, as Gilbert told us, Mr. Lamb, isn't enough to get down to the lower level. So we're going to have to do something about that. And the way we do something about that is by going into security services. And we get in, and we got some special operations here, which is 2. Okay, so we got file adjustment, which we done. We did it in Gilbert Lamb to make him a D-link so we could get into his apartment. But there's a special thing that we can do here, special status request. And what this will do, authority granted for temporary enhancement of link status. Agent granted access to all sectors, duration 48 hours. So what this does is it allows us to go down floors, because if we look at ourselves now, we go to personal, we'll notice that our link status is now unlimited. So that means that we can go anywhere basically in Union City and talk to anyone we want to, more or less. Okay, so let's bellow that. The other good thing about this is, remember I was talking about the scanner and it would kill us if we did the wrong thing? Well, we can use the lift door now. I like how Sam and Norval don't bat an eye. We just came from inside of their security area, which we were told not to go into. And now they're not even worried about us. Anyway, so let's leave here. Actually, let's just see if they say anything about that. Nope. Okay. And Norval? No. Ah. I was hoping they would have something witty to say about that whole deal. Okay, so I want to say the lift is this way to go downward. Yes, I'm remembering correctly. Let's go down. And then we go. Now, if you'll recall, we left Joey on the second level, so he should still be there. There we go. Oh. I'll leave that like it is for a minute, because we're gonna go down one more level. And this was the elevator we couldn't use before. So, let's go there. I'm interested in the fact that he didn't tell Joey to join him. Oh no, Joey must have forgotten he'd changed shells. I hope his board isn't broken. Okay, so let's... I want to move that junk. It's too heavy to carry. The good news is that we got Joey's circuit board. And that's all that matters here. Right. So here's a guard. Let's talk to him to start off with. What's through that door? Do you know the woman with the dog? What's the best way out of the city? There isn't a way out. Oh. Then inhabitants are no better than prisoners. Oh, sorry, that's the price of progress. Sorry, they're the same font color, so I keep getting confused about who's talking. Oh yes, that's Miss Piermont. The richest woman in Union City. And the ugliest. Ah, that's not very nice, guy. What's through the door? It's off limits to the likes of you. I just wondered where it leads. It's the old cathedral. There's nothing interesting in there. In fact, it's empty. Why guard an empty cathedral? Good question. I'm not guarding it exactly. I'm just standing here, preventing me from entering. Yeah. Never mind. Okay, so Miss Piermont is like Mr. Lamb, in a sense that she's going to be walking a specific route. There's nothing else much to see and do here with the guard right now, and we got everything that we wanted from the junk. Let's have a look at this contraption here. It's pivoted to the middle, in the middle, like a seesaw. A pallet of bricks suspended from a pulley. Okay, that's important to know about. We're not going to do anything with it yet, but let's just have a little walk around. Okay, so there's a doorman here. There's the exit there. There's a door over there. Let's talk to the doorman. Oh goodness. We're not going to be able to... Okay, hang on. Here's what we'll do. We'll look at the statue and hopefully that means Miss Piermont will move. The big guy's sacks are spilling their content. Okay, very good. Let's now go talk to Norman. Excuse me. Hold it. Your membership card, please. I don't have one. This is a private club. Oh, I didn't know that. You do now. Piss off. How do I join the club? Smart shoes. See you later. Thanks. You can tell a lot from a man's shoes. The design tells you what kind of man he is. The way he cares for him tells you where he's going. And what he's trodden in tells you where he's been. How do I get into the club? You have to be sponsored by an existing member. It's a most exclusive establishment. Frequented only by those with the proper credentials. You mean people with money? No, people with credit. There's a world of difference. People with money think they can afford not to care. People with credit know they can't, but don't care anyway. What goes on in a club? Do you know anyone who'd sponsor me? See you later. If I was to tell you that this club provides recreational facilities par excellence for a clientele with elegance and taste, I'd be lying through my teeth. You just said it was exclusive. It is exclusive, but seedy. The reason people come here is the cheap booze. and the fact that it's off-limits to security. Do you know someone who'd sponsor me? What about old Widow Piermont? She used to come here years ago. If you chatted her up, she might sponsor you. I don't know Miss Piermont personally. You must have seen her with her dog. Miss Piermont is the one with two legs. Just like a proper doorman. And he does his lapels too, it's amazing. This is a door. I don't think we can go in here yet. Doors are unremarkable, but this one has a certain je ne sais quoi. Je ne sais pas. Sorry. The other is different. There's a sign there. Court closed. See Link news of forthcoming attractions. Oh, goodness. I notice it's glued to the door. Shut tight. Right. We are going to eventually interact with Miss Piermont, but we're not going to do it quite yet. Hello, puppy. There's another statue. It's a little man carrying a log. We're going to go this way. I just want to walk around and have a look before we do anything. Okay, there's a door here. The door has an old-fashioned lock on it. Won't open. That's probably because it's locked. Right, now we have no way of it's very difficult to find. There's the lock. Where's the lock? This is one of those rare times. It's an old-fashioned cylinder lock. I need a key to open that. It's one of those rare times where I wish this game had a system where you could tab and see all the bits and pieces. Okay, so let's head this way. And we can go over here. There is, of course, a Link terminal here. There's a gardener. And there's a lift here that goes to a building. We can also go to the left here. So let's start just by talking to the different people. Hello? Who are you? My name's Vincent. What's yours? I'm Robert. You can call me Rob. Why aren't you at school, Vincent? What's that you're playing with? Do you know a man called Overman? Don't wear out your thumb. My tutor has malfunctioned. I tried to reprogram it to play video games. Would you like me to repair your tutor? Haven't you got any human friends? I think that's the one to go for. It's a little sad that he's just not that tutor. Of course I have. None of them will play with me, though. Because I always beat them. What's that you're playing with? It's my handheld games console. Neat. What's the game? It's called Fleecy the Lamb. That sounds nice. What's the objective? Torture the mutant psychos with your flamethrower. And stop Dr. Mantis from butchering the orphan. But that's horrible. Yeah, I played better. What other games have you got? Do you know a man called Overman? Not many. Because they're too expensive. They're smuggled into the city from Hobart. I've got Nobby, the platform game. Onan, the barbarian. And Revenge of the Deadly Dandelions. I suppose they keep you out of mischief. The second game there is a pun. Do you know a man called Overman? No, Rob. What do you want to know? He's my dad. Aren't you a little old to have a dad? Last time I saw him, I was a little boy. I was taken away to the Gap. The Gap? Oh, wow. I'd like to escape to the Gap. I'm tired of being told what to do. Do you know the woman with the dog? That's Miss Piermont, and she's a pig. Ugh. That's not a very nice thing to say. Well, she tried to confiscate my console. She gave me a lecture and tried to force me to join the Junior Security Corps. Can you sponsor me for the club? Look, I'm just a kid, right? Do you really think they make me a member? I don't think so. Have you been watching old movies? I think that's a reference to a movie that I don't know, because I'm not very good with movies. God, no. Excuse me. Smart floral display there. Are they real? What do you think? They look kind of shiny. Naturally, I've just varnished them. Do you paint the flowers too? This is Union City, not Wonderland. You obviously know nothing about plants. Won't the varnish harm the plants? What is blue flowers called? See you later. Au contraire, clever dick. It filters out the crap and atmosphere. What are you doing to that plant? I'm modeling living sculpture. It's called topiary, and it's an art form. They're dandelions. Don't touch them. They're pretty, but why can't I touch them? Because if you do, you'll wet your bed. Well, I haven't done it in months. They're making very awkward color choices here. It's very difficult to read the text. I wish they wouldn't do that. Anyway, here's a linc terminal. Let's just access it very quickly. And the reason why I want to access it is because I want to just look at Union City News. Because oh, okay, they haven't caught up with me yet. Okay, that's good. Right. So, we can't get in here yet, but we can see that there are buttons. It's the call button for an apartment. So this is an apartment complex, obviously. No card slot. Must be a private lift. Let's go this way. And this leads us back to here. Now, there's the exit. Okay. Didn't see where the exit would be for that particular room. Let's talk to Miss Piermont. Excuse me. Hello. I don't believe we've met. No, I'm a stranger here. I'm Miss Piermont. But you can call me Danielle. Would you sponsor me for the club? How do I get out of the city? Do you know someone called Overman? Now why would you want to do that? There's nothing in the gap but sand and savages. But that's where I live. How ghastly for you, my dear. What's the mutt's name? Well, really, he's not a mutt. His name is Spunky. He looks just like his owner. He looks like he's got fleas. Aw, I don't want to say mean things to people. Don't make me do this. This is like the lesser of the two evils, but it's still evil. He has millions of them. But he's allergic to flea powder. Why don't you give him a good bath? I've tried. He won't bear to go to get wet. Would you sponsor me for the club? Oh no, I couldn't do that. Why not? As you said yourself, you're a stranger. Why, you could be a terrorist. No, no, it's out of the question. Okay, so let's talk to her again. Excuse me. Let's talk to her about Overman. Why, yes, I do. He worked with my husband, Professor Piermont. Why are you interested in Overman? He was my father. I'm sorry, but I don't believe you. Overman's only son died in an accident. That was no accident, Miss Piermont. It was deliberate sabotage by security. My mother was killed, but I survived. And I've had a document. I've read a document which proves it. Incredible. Your mother was a great friend to me. If you really, Robert Overman, I'll sponsor you. Meet me at my apartment. Conveniently, we're at her apartment. Come to Mommy, Spunky. Now, we have to wait for this whole thing to happen. Actually, can I just press the button? No, I have to actually wait for Spunky. Oh my goodness. Okay. Hello, who is this? Security, open up. It's me, Robert, your pizza madam. I would save and try all these. I didn't know that there was going to be a choice. So let's do it's me, Robert. Come right in, Rob. I keep forgetting that at some junctures they're going to ask me questions and make me go through multiple things. Welcome to my humble little home, Robert. You know, I remember you as a baby, Robert. I've grown a bit since then. I'm sure you have. You must have so many questions to ask me. Yes, I have. Okay, so what was the professor working on? Is my father still alive? Why didn't you want to visit the club? Let's start there, since that's the least interesting of the three topics we can talk about. The memories are too painful. Did you go there with the professor? Yes. We met in the club. He was a handsome young graduate. And I was like a flower in first bloom. He plucked me from the garden of innocence. I see what you mean. The memories are painful. What was the professor working on? Let's do that. Didn't I tell you? Helmut was the designer of Link. It was his dream, but it died before it was realized. Your father Richard became the project leader. My dad was responsible for Link. Is my father still alive? Yes, he stepped into Helmut's shoes. Link reached completion on the very day you were born. From then on, Richard changed. He spent more time with Link than he did with his wife and the baby. Why did my mother try to escape? She did her best to cope. But she wasn't the same after Richard's rejection. The authorities never approved of her marriage either. Because she came from Hobart. Eventually she decided to return home. So the bastards had her killed. You overwrought, Robert. Would you like some paracetamol? I don't want analgesic. I want answers. Is my father still alive? I've not seen him since my husband's funeral. What a magnificent occasion. I wish I could have stayed until the end. You walked out of your husband's funeral? I had no choice. West Spunky hates cathedral. All that incense and droning makes him bilious. No sooner had I got him outside, when up came his back. It's a good thing he didn't chuck in church. Don't interrupt, darling. Well, when I got back, they were gone. Congregation, choir, coffin, and all. Are you gonna sponsor me now? If that's what you want, I'll telephone the manager and make the arrangements. This won't take a moment. Okay, so while she's gone, is that Mr. Colston? Daniel Pyrmont here. I have a friend I wish to sponsor. Okay, so while she's doing that, let's take our tape and do this. I really need to do this in here. I don't believe it. Quite so. Yes, I understand. Oh. If I pick up the ball, the contents will slop all over my hands. It's full of biscuits and dog drool. Okay. Oh, right, hang on. Let's get some dog biscuits. Okay. None of the buttons do any good. What you'd expect them to. Okay, so let's talk to Miss Pyrmont. Excuse me. Won't keep you long, Death Boy. Really? Dear Boy? Oh, it's Dear Boy. Sorry. Okay. So, now we need to do a bit of a dastardly thing, but we're going to do that when next I see you. because it is the end of the episode. So, with that in mind, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you've been enjoying Beneath the Steel Sky as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now.